So I am going to share with you a very, very interesting topic today. Okay, it is still the same thing. Accounting software with double entries. So this time I am actually showing you the Xero accounting software because this was a request by one of our audience. Okay, he has actually asked me to do this. So I hope you will gain something from this and also benefit from this. Please share around, comment, and also like this video if you really can understand this. So apart from that, I'm also going to share with you another video which is going to be coming up very, very soon. This is going to be very interesting too because I am sharing about how accounting and auditing actually relates together. So that will be super fun and hope you all will enjoy it. Now let's go to the Xero accounting software with double entries. So first thing first, I'm going to show you what is the company name, what is the nature of the business, because that is very, very important. Once you know what is the nature of the business and you roughly will know what are the sales and the expenses of the company. So here, the company's name that I've created, as you all know, Crazy Geeks and Rubber Hut. So Crazy Geeks and Rubber Hut is a company that does accounting and also bookkeeping, as well as secretarial services. So four things I'm going to cover for this session also: cash purchases, cash sales, trade receivables, as well as trade payables. So first thing, I'm going to click onto this plus sign. Okay, if you can see this plus sign, you can see into invoice. Okay. Okay, I'm going to go into keying in invoice. So, you know, if you're really into this software, you can add all the details that you need. So here, just for the learning purpose, I'm just going to put something like more. Okay, and then the date, due date. Okay. So I'm also going to put the exact same date, the invoice, and then the reference number. Okay. After that, you can key in the item that you want. If you have the item, the description, the quantity, how many, unit price, and then the account. Okay, account is a very important one because this is where you're going to show where is the double entry is going to be. So choose any one of it. It needs to be revenue related, so sales. Okay, then and then the amount. Okay, this is what you will know. You need to know. So the double entry here will be very simple: debit your trade receivables, credit your sales. Okay, so all the way down you will click on the approve. Okay, if not, you go to save and someone else need to approve, then you need to approve. I'm not going to click save here because I've already done that. Okay, so that is one. Now let's go to the bill. Okay, bill is where you will actually record your trade payables, or else it is known as trade suppliers. Okay, so from I'm purchasing stationaries for my accounting and bookkeeping related, so maybe files, stationery, something like that. So I'm going to put it's a bookstore. Okay, maybe my bookstore. Okay, so you enter your date, your due date is the same date, and then you can key in the item description, quantity, unit price. So I'm going to jump all the way into the account. So I'm going to go all the way down to printing and stationery, and the amount is maybe 500. Okay, so you enter, so it's 500. That is all. Then you approve. Okay, simple. So the double entry here was you debit your printing and stationery, which is the expenses, then you credit the trade payables. So done. Okay, now you are going to, okay, this is done, right? So now I'm going to show you how to record the cash received and cash paid for both the transaction that we did before. So you go to the business, you go to the invoices. Okay, so when you go to the invoices, you can see this invoice, which is the status is awaiting payment. So just click on this. Okay, once you clicked on this, then it says here add payment. If you go all the way down, the amount paid is still same, the date paid, Okay, I'm going to put the same date and paid to whom? Paid to which account? Give me bank. Okay, and you, if you have any reference, you can just put a reference and payment. Okay, so simple, very simple. So you save once, that is thing. Okay, done. So now let's go to the bills to pay. Okay, this is the Amat bookstore. So you can just click on this. Okay, so you make a payment. So now on the same date, paid from which account? This bank account. And you add payment, meaning your money is going off from your bank. So add payment. Okay, that is all. So I made the payment. Now let's go to the cash purchases. Okay, you're purchasing something using your cash. Okay, so the bank that you use, if you're using petty cash, then create an account called petty cash. Next. Okay, so this one spent as what? Is it a direct payment or prepayment or payment? Okay, to whom? Okay, again here I'm going to maybe put I'm going to purchase, maybe I'm just paying for salaries, maybe. So my employee's name, Miss Anu. Okay, my contact and description, quantity is maybe this one, and this one is a salary, maybe 2000. And then the account here, wages and salary. Okay, so this is all save and okay, save and add. So this is an expense. So if you have a purchases, then you just put a purchase. Okay, after that, I'm going to show you another one, which is your money coming into your bank. So it can be very easy one. Maybe it can also be something like interest income. If you have a fixed deposit account, then through that you're actually getting interest, right? So from is still Maybank. And then you have the date, the description, quantity is one. Then the unit price here can be maybe 300 for a month. Or maybe it's too much, maybe 30 ringgit. Okay. Then the account, you can always choose interest income. And this is it, 30 ringgit. Save. Okay, simple. You can see. It's very, very simple. And now for you to check whether all the transactions have been correctly picked up, you go to the accounting, you go to the reports, then you can go to straight away to the general ledger. Okay, general ledger. So here, general ledger, very simple. So when you, the moment you click on it, and then you can now know already which are the accounting entries we have picked up. So here it's very nicely done. It's general ledger summary. Okay, so it's a summary. They're not going to give you a very detailed one, but it's a summary. So just now when we key in, we debited first transactions on credit purchases. We actually debited the expenses, which is printing and stationery, and then we credited the accounts payable. Then when we pay it, we will debit back the accounts payable and we credit the bank 500. Okay, so after that, we have our trade receivables. So we send an invoice to the customer. So we debit our accounts receivable, we credit our sales. And then when the person paid, we credit the trade receivables and then we debit our bank. Okay, clear? And then the next one was cash, the interest income. So the interest income, how we put is you debit your bank, the 30 ringgit, and you credit your interest income. The same thing for the purchases. Okay, for the purchases, we actually put it as wages and salaries, right? So we debit the wages and salary 2000, and then we credit the other 2000 in our bank. So this is it. you know, very easy, very simple, straightforward to understand. So I hope you can understand this well. And I'm going to put the link below to show how to purchase this accounting software. Do try this out, understand this, and then you're all the way out there and you can do phenomenal things in your accounting. So have fun. Bye. Stay tuned.